Hi, I'm Mike Massimino, former NASA astronaut and now the Senior Advisor for Space Programs at the Intrepid Sea, Air, and Space Museum. This year marks the 50th anniversary of the Apollo 11 moon landing, the first mission that put humans on the moon. Back in July of 1969, I was just 6 years old, but the Apollo 11 astronauts, Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, and Mike Collins, had a huge influence on me. They inspired me to learn about the space program, become an engineer, and aspire to be an astronaut. As a NASA astronaut, I had the honor of flying twice on the space shuttle. I was a spacewalker on those missions and got to work on the Hubble Space Telescope. The amazing accomplishment of landing on the moon is a story of enduring effort, scientific breakthroughs, personal sacrifice, and incredible engineering. I would like to share with you one aspect of this story, and that is the engineering behind the vehicle that launched the astronauts to the moon, the incredible Saturn V rocket. The Saturn V rocket was the first super heavy lift launch vehicle developed by the United States. It was developed at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama. It was the third and most powerful vehicle to be developed in the Saturn family of rockets. The Saturn I and the Saturn I-B were smaller rockets used to launch astronauts and uncrewed spacecraft into Earth orbit. The Saturn V was needed to get all the way to the moon and back. The Saturn V rockets were three-stage, liquid-fueled, super-heavy lift vehicles. They were 363 feet tall. That's as tall as a 36-story building and about 60 feet taller than the Statue of Liberty. Fully fueled for liftoff, the Saturn V weighed 6.2 million pounds. This was an immensely large and complicated machine. Let's take a look at it one piece at a time, starting at the bottom. The first stage of the Saturn V rocket burned liquid propellant through a cluster of five F1 engines, producing a combined 7.6 million pounds of thrust and could launch 130 tons of payload into Earth orbit. That's about as much weight as 10 school buses, but the Saturn V was designed to get 50 tons of spacecraft all the way to the moon. The first stage engines got the giant rocket off the ground and burned for about 2.5 minutes. This stage takes the vehicle and payload to an altitude of 38 miles, about half the way to low Earth orbit. It then separates and falls into the sea. Before we talk about the rest of the vehicle, let's look at the very top of the rocket. This is the launch escape system. The launch escape system was designed to take the command module containing the astronauts away from the launch vehicle in the case of an emergency on the pad or shortly after launch. The system carries the command module to a sufficient height and to the side, away from the launch vehicle, so that the parachute system can operate. It is actually a rocket connected to the command module by a tower. In an abort from the pad, the launch escape system will carry the command module to a height of about 4,000 feet before it is jettisoned and the parachutes deploy. Luckily, it was never used on any of the crewed Saturn flights. Let's get back to the rocket. The Saturn V second stage contained a cluster of five J2 engines that burned liquid hydrogen and oxygen. After the first stage was discarded, the second stage engines ignited and burned for approximately 6 minutes, taking the vehicle and payload to 115 miles high. Like the first stage, the second stage was then discarded. Once the second stage of the Saturn V reached a height of 115 miles, and a speed of 15,500 miles per hour, the Saturn V single-engine third stage ignited, burning for about 2 minutes to place the Apollo spacecraft into a parking orbit. After a thorough equipment check in Earth orbit, the third stage engine reignited and pushed the vehicle to a velocity of 25,000 miles per hour. This was enough to escape Earth's gravitational pull and head for the moon. This maneuver was called translunar injection. Now let's look at the top of the rocket. These components are the heart and brain of the vehicle. This is the command module and the service module. Let's look at the command module first. The command module is the control center and living quarters for most of the lunar mission. One man will spend the entire mission in it, while the other two will take the lunar module down for the landing. It measured 12 feet 10 inches in diameter, 10 feet 7 inches high, and weighed 13,000 pounds fully loaded. This is the only part of the spacecraft that returns to Earth at the end of the mission, and it is not reusable. The astronauts were able to leave their seats and move about the spacecraft. The seat portion of the couches folded up to to allow for more room. The astronauts had sleeping bags that could be mounted on the walls of the module and had restraints so astronauts could sleep within the sleeping bag. Storage for food, water, and clothing, as well as a waste management station, lined the interior walls. At the top or smaller pointy end of the command module was a tunnel and hatch. There was also a mechanism to attach the command module to the lunar module. Normal pressure in the cabin was about 5 pounds per square inch. That's about a third of Earth's sea level. And the temperature was controlled at 75 degrees. This meant that the crew could spend much of the time out of their spacesuits. Spacesuits were necessary, however, for risky maneuvers, such as launch, docking, entry, and crew transfer. The command module protected the crew from the temperature extremes of space, which could be as cold as 280 degrees Fahrenheit below zero, or as hot as 280 degrees Fahrenheit above zero in direct sunlight. And most critical, the temperature of re-entry, a blistering 5,000 degrees Fahrenheit. The command module also has the parachute landing system, which slows the spacecraft down for a gentle landing in the ocean. The service module contains spacecraft propulsion and maneuvering systems, electrical generation systems, and most of the spacecraft's consumables, like oxygen, water, propellant, and hydrogen. It is not manned. The module's main propulsion engine was used to brake the spacecraft and put it into lunar orbit, and later to break free from lunar orbit and send the astronauts back to Earth. The service module remains attached to the command module until just before re-entry into the Earth's atmosphere, when it is jettisoned and is burned up as it lacks any of the heat shield found on the command module. All the parts we talked about so far will get you to the moon and back home, but to land on the moon's surface will take a really special spaceship. The lunar module, or LM, pronounced LEM, was designed to carry two astronauts from lunar orbit to the lunar surface and return them back to the command and service modules waiting for them in lunar orbit. While on the moon's surface, it was designed to be living quarters and a base of operations. The LEM consists of two main parts, a descent stage and an ascent stage. The descent stage had the rocket motor that slowed the LEM for a soft landing on the surface. It also carried all the scientific experiments and gear the astronauts would need for exploration. It ultimately would serve as the launch platform for the ascent stage and was left on the lunar surface. The ascent stage houses the crew, an engine for the return to lunar orbit, and all the flight controls. It has essentially the same subsystems found in the command and service modules. When sitting on the moon, the LEM was over 23 feet tall. There are two hatches, a docking hatch at the top for access to the command module, and a forward hatch, which is used to provide access to the lunar surface. When the astronauts went outside, they had to climb down a long ladder that was attached to one of the landing legs. At the bottom of the ladder is the foot pad. It was about 37 inches in diameter. Imagine Neil Armstrong standing on the inside of this foot pad, then taking that first step off. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. About halfway down the ladder, attached to the landing strut of the Apollo 11 LEM, is a plaque commemorating the first moon landing. It reads, "Here men from the planet Earth first set foot upon the moon, July 1969 AD. We came in peace for all mankind." The Saturn V rocket was the culmination of a decade of work and sacrifice by thousands of people. So far, it is the only machine ever built that could carry people to another place off the Earth. For more videos about space and the other collections here at the Intrepid Museum, visit intrepidmuseum.org.